स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज निधि घेटिया। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द बेसिक्स ऑफ द फाइटोकेमिस्ट्री। ओके, सो लेट्स बी स्टार्टेड विद द स्टडी ऑफ द कंटेंट। सो टुडे वी विल स्टडी द फाइटोकेमिस्ट्री, देन डेफिनेशन ऑफ द फाइटोकेमिस्ट्री, देन एक्सट्रैक्शन, देन टाइप ऑफ द एक्सट्रैक्ट्स और आइडियल प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द सॉल्वेंट फॉर द एक्सट्रैक्शन प्रोसेस एंड देन मेथड ऑफ द एक्सट्रैक्शन। ओके, सो लेट्स वी स्टार्ट विद द फाइटोकेमिस्ट्री। सो व्हाट इज फाइटोकेमिस्ट्री? सो द कंस्टिट्यूएंट्स व्हिच पोजेस द फार्माकोलॉजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज, दैट्स कॉल्ड द एक्टिव कंस्टिट्यूएंट्स। ओके, सो द कंस्टिट्यूएंट्स व्हिच पोजेस द दे इंट्रोड्यूस द फार्माकोलॉजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज, दैट्स कॉल्ड द एक्टिव कंस्टिट्यूएंट्स। बट दे कंस्टिट्यूएंट्स दे टोटली कंसर्न्ड विद द केमिस्ट्री स्टडी, सो दैट्स कॉल्ड द फाइटोकेमिस्ट्री। ओके, फाइटोकेमिस्ट्री दैट कंसर्न्ड विद द केमिकल स्टडी ऑफ द प्लांट कंस्टिट्यूएंट्स, दैट्स कॉल्ड द फाइटोकेमिस्ट्री। Or another definition, that is the active constituents directly concerned with the their chemical study of the plant constituents, that's called the phytochemistry. Okay, now we will study the extraction. So what is extraction? So extraction is the method of removing active constituents from a solid or liquid by means of liquid solvent. So the separation of medicinally active portion of the plant or animal tissues from the inactive or inert components by using selective solvents. So in this method, the wanted components are dissolved by the using of the selective solvents known as the menstruum, and undissolved part is the mark. Okay, so after the extraction, unwanted matter is removed and then extract are prepared by using ethanol or other suitable solvent. Okay, so this is the method for the removing acting constituents from the solid or liquid any liquid solvents by using the any liquid solvents. So the separation, this is the process of the separation of the medicinally active portion of plant or animal tissues from the inactive or inert component using the their selective solvents. So in this method, the wanted components are dissolved by using the selective solvent, and their dissolved portion, that known as the menstruum, and undissolved portion, that's called the murk. So after the extraction process, unwanted matter, that is murk, is removed, and then extract are prepared by using the ethanol or other suitable solvents. Okay, so the extract, that is extract, can be defined as the preparation of crude drug using which contain all the constituents which are soluble in the solvent. Okay, extract that is the preparation of the crude drug which contain all the constituents which are soluble in the solvent. Then murk, that is the solid residue obtained after the extraction process, that is undissolved part, and menstruum, that is the solvent using for the extraction. Okay, then now we will see the type of the extract. So mainly three types of the extract. First one, that is dry, second one, that is the soft, and third one, that is the liquid. Okay, so in dry, that is tablet or capsule, like example, that is the belladonna extract. Okay, they are available in the dry extract. Then soft, that is ointment and suppository, that is glycyrrhizic extract. Okay, then liquid, that is as a tincture. Okay, so this is the type of the extract, that is three type. First one, dry extract, second one, soft extract, and third one, that is the liquid extract. Okay, then now we will see the mechanism of the extraction process. So dissolve the extractive substance out of the disintegrated cell. So dissolution of the extractive substance out of the intact plant cell by diffusion so requires the stepping and swelling procedure. Okay, so they penetrate the solvent into the plant shell and swelling of the cells. Then diffusion of the dissolved extractive substance out of the cell. Okay, so dissolution of the extractive substance, that is the extraction, you know, extraction process, extractive substance that dissolve in the disintegrated substance out of the disintegrated cell. So dissolution of the extractive substance out of the intact plant cell by diffusion method. Okay, so in this this method that two required step, that is the swelling and stepping. First one, that is stepping, and second one, that is swelling procedure. Then they penetrate the solvent into the plant shell and swelling of the cells. So the diffusion of the dissolved extractive substance out of the cell. Okay, then plant constituents are usually contained inside the cell, therefore the solvent used for extraction must diffuse into the cell by dissolve the desired compounds, whereupon the solution must pass the cell wall in the opposite direction and mixed with the surrounding liquid. So an equilibrium is established between the solute inside the cell and the solvent surrounding the fragmented plant tissues. Okay, now we will see the ideal properties of the solvent, types of the solvent, or best property of the solvent. So be highly selective for the compound to be extracted, then no react with the extract compound or with the other compounds in the plant material. Then third one, that is having a lower price. Then be harmful less to man and to the environment. Be completely volatile. Okay, then should not mix up with the water. Then should have the big capacity in the relation to extractive. Okay, first property, that is highly selective for the compound to the extraction. And second one, that is no react with the extracted compound or with the other compound in the plant material. And third one, that is the lowering the price. Then fourth one, harmless to the man and also environment. Then completely volatile in nature. Then should not mix up with the water and should have the big capacity in the relation to extractive. So the density of the solvent should be difference from the water density. Okay, so should have the minimum than viscosity of the solvent. Okay, now we will see the some factors of the affecting in the extraction process. So first, that is the nature of the drug. Then second one, that is the solvents. Third one, that is the temperature, also pH and also particle size. Okay, first, that is the nature of the drug. Then second one, solvent. Then temperature. Then pH and also particle size. These all are the factors that affecting in the extraction process. Then now we will see the method of the extraction. So here infusion, decoction, then digestion, then maceration, then percolation, then continuous hot extraction, also known as the Soxhlet extraction process, then supercritical fluid extraction, then counter current extraction, then microwave assisted extraction and ultrasonication assisted extraction. These all are the method of the extraction. Okay, so let's be started with the infusion. So the infusion method, fresh infusion are prepared by the macerating the crude drug for the short period of time with cold or boiling water. So these are dilute solution of the readily soluble constituents of the crude drug. So here two types of the their process. The first one, that is the fresh infusion. So their example, that is the infusion of the orange. Then concentrated infusion, that is the infusion of the quassia bark. Okay, so this is the infusion method. Now we will see the decoction method. So in this process, that is the decoction method, the crude drug is boiled in the specific volume of water for the defining time period, some time limiting. So it is then cooled and strained and filtered. Okay, strained or filter. This procedure is suitable for the extractive water soluble heat stable constituents. Okay, in this process, first we take the crude drug, they're boiling in the some specific amount of the water, some specific volume of the water, or for the defining timeline, and after then cooled out, and they strained or filtered. Okay, so this procedure is suitable for the extractive water soluble heat stable constituents. Their example, that is tea and coffee. Okay, now we will see the rejection. So this is the form of maceration in which gentle heat is used during the process of extraction. So it is used when moderately elevated temperature so is not objectable. So the solvent efficiency of the menstruum is thereby increased. Okay, so first we take the this digestion. This is a form of the maceration which gently heated during the whole process of the extraction. Okay, so in this method, use the moderately elevated temperature is not acceptable. So the solvent efficiency of the menstruum is thereby increased. So their example, that is the extraction of the morphine. Now we will see the maceration process. So in maceration process, in this process, solid ingredients are placed in a stoppered container with the wall of solvent and allowed to stand for the some period of the time, at least around 3 days with the frequent 3 to 7 days with the frequent agitation until the soluble matter in dissolved. Okay, first we take the solid ingredient, that is the crude drug ingredient, then this is placed in the one stoppered container or bottle, then with the solvent and allow for the stand for the some time period around 3 to 7 days with frequent agitation until the soluble matter is dissolved. So this mixture is then strained through the sieve or net. So the murk pressed and combined liquid clarified, so the clarified, that is cleaned by the filtration or by decoction, and after the standing. Okay, decantation and after the standing. So this is the process in the flowchart. First we take the plant material, that is the crushed or cut small or in a moderately coarse powder, then placed in the closed vessel or container, then with the some solvent, wall of the selected solvent, and that is the menstruum added. then allow to stand for this 3 to 7 days, and sacking in occasionally for the agitation process. Then liquid strained off, then solid residue, that is mark, pressed for the recover as much occulated solution, then strain and express the liquid mixture, then clarified by the subsidence or filtration. Then after this process, they go for the evaporation and concentration. Okay, this is the process of the maceration. Now we will see the some types of the maceration process. So this is the simple maceration, double maceration and triple maceration. Okay, for the simple maceration, for organ is organized or unorganized crude drug. Okay, simple maceration for the organized and unorganized crude drugs, like example, like the tincture of the orange, lemon and squill, organized and unorganized crude drug, that is tincture of the orange, tincture of the lemon and tincture of the squill. Then double maceration, that is for the concentrated infusion of orange. Then triple maceration, so the maceration process may be carried out with help of the heat or stirring. So their example, that is concentrated infusion of the quassia and senna. Okay, this is the three types of the maceration: simple, double and triple. Okay, now we will see the next one method, that is percolation. So it is the continuous downward displacement of the solvent through the bed of crude drug material to get extract. So most frequently used to extract active ingredients in the preparation of tincture and some fluid extraction, that is the some solvent. Then it is the method of short successive maceration or process of the displacement. Okay, in this is the continuous downward displacement of the solvent through the bed or crude drug material to get the extract. This is the most frequently used to extract for the active ingredients in the preparation of tincture and fluid extractor. So it is the method of short successive maceration or process of displacement. This method done by the one percolator, that is the percolator in two on the different shape, that is the first, that is the narrowing shape, then cone shaped, then vessel open at the both end, and they generally these used. Okay, cone shape, these generally use this percolator. Two types of the percolator: first one, that is cylindrical, and second one, that is the cone shaped. Okay, cone shape, that you must generally the cone shaped percolator are used. So in cone shaped percolator, they length, the thickness, that is narrowing. Then cone shaped vessel, you open at both end side. Okay, this is the percolator, cone shaped percolator. So menstruum upper part, that is the menstruum, then in between washed sand, then filter the filter paper, then drug collected, and glass wool. Okay, this is the cone shaped percolator. Now we will see the succlation or succlate extraction or continuous extraction. Okay, so the succlate extractor, continuous extraction of the components from the solid mixture. This method is widely used in the industrial Ayurvedic industries. So the succlate extractor, continuous extraction of the components from a solid mixture. So boiling the solvent, vapor rise up through the larger side arm, so condense the drop of the solvent fall into the porous cup, then dissolving out the desired components from a solid mixture. When the smaller side arm fill the overflowing, it initiated a symphonic action. So the solvent containing the dissolved component is siphoned into the boiler, and below the residual solvent, this then drain out of the porous cup, and as a fresh solvent drop continues to fall into the porous cup. This cycle they repeats. Okay, so this is the percolation Soxhlet apparatus figure. First, that is a siphon tube in below heating mantle, any heating source, then a distillation flask, then a siphon tube, or also having the thimble, then they covered with the side tubes, and then water inlet or outlet, then one conditioner for the cooling purpose. Okay, now we will see the merit and demerits of the Soxhlet extraction. So the large amount of drug can be extracted with the much smaller quantity of solvent, and tremendous economy in the term of time, energy, and ultimately financial input. Small scale used a batch process and become more economical when converted into the continuous extraction, so processor on large scale. Okay, this is the merit, that is advantages of the Soxhlet extraction process. Then demerits, that is disadvantage of physical nature of the drug. This is the disadvantage of the this process. Then also solvent and chemical constituents of the drug. These three demerits of the Soxhlet extraction. Then now we will see the supercritical fluid process. So for the every substance, there is critical temperature. Okay, critical temperature denoted with the TC, and simple pressure, that is denoted with the PC. So above which no applied pressure can force the substance into the liquid phase. Okay, so if the temperature and pressure of substance are both higher than the TC and PC, so the substance is defined as the supercritical fluid. Okay, critical temperature and pressure, they no applied pressure can be substance into the liquid phase, but the applying the temperature and pressure of the substance are both in the higher than TC and PC for that substance, so they call they define as the substance they defined as the supercritical fluid. Okay, now we will see the countercurrent extraction process. So a liquid extraction process in which the solvent and the process stream is in the contact with the each other flow in opposite direction. So the screw extractor and carousel extractor are two types of the equipment for use for the countercurrent extraction process. Okay, first, liquid extraction process in which solvent and the process in this process stream in contact with each other flow in opposite direction. This is the countercurrent extraction. Then two types of the countercurrent extraction equipment, that is screw extractor and carousel extractor. Now we will see the microwave assistant extraction. So microwave are electromagnetic radiation with a frequency of from the about 0.3 to 300 GHz. Camel 2001, that is the number of their instrument model. Okay, microwave and electromagnetic radiation with the frequency from 0.3 to 300 GHz. Camel 2001, that is the model number. So in order to avoid interference with the radio communication, domestic and industrial microwave generally operate at the 2.45 GHz, that is the unit of the microwave frequency or frequency, showing to their electromagnetic nature. Microwave opposes the electric and magnetic field, so which are perpendicular to each other. So the electric field causing the heat via two simultaneously mechanism, namely dipolar rotation and ionic conduction. Okay, microwave are generate the electromagnetic radiation with the some frequency level. So in order of the inference with the radio communication, domestic industry microwave generally operated at the specific frequency, that is 2.45 GHz. So electromagnetic nature and microwave poses the electric and magnetic field which are perpendicular to each other. Okay, they generate the electric and magnetic field which are perpendicular with the each other. So the electric field causing the heat, via two simultaneous mechanism, that is dipolar rotation and ionic conduction. This is the microwave assisted extraction process. Now we will end this session of the basics of phytochemistry. Today we learn introduction of the phytochemistry, that is the definition, and also we learn the extraction process, their mechanism, also properties and their method. Okay, so now thank you to all.